Sure be good to see my cousin Jed again.
I can't wait to meet him.
Like, what does Jed do, Fred?
He makes monsters.
Monsters? You know what? I just remembered I've got something on the stove. Me and Scoob have to go back.
Relax, you scaredy cats. Jed works for a special effects studio. They make fake monsters for movies.
Here we are. Monstrous Fright and Magic. Monsters while you wait.
Sure. And like, do you mind if we wait in the van?
Jeepers! What happened here?
Like, I'll never understand creative types, but I do groove on their style.
Jed! It's Fred!
This place has been completely ransacked.
All right, gang. Let's split up and see if we can find any clues.
Scooby-Doo! Where are you?
Oh, boy. What is that?
Scoob, like all the Scooby snacks in this room are making me hungry. I bet you can't find all of them. Okay.
Scooby, I was trying to find out how to open this door. That's the switch over there, but I don't know how to get to it. Maybe there's a clue somewhere.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
This key card... Great! You found a clue. It's some sort of key card. Bingo. Now try to see if you can reach that switch, Scooby. Great job, Scooby. I'll go show this clue to the others.
Hey, Scooby. Velma and Daphne went to check out the workshop that way.
Huh?
You'll need to slide down that cable to follow them.
I'm so glad you're here. You've got to help Velma. She's been cornered by these two huge rats. Try to scare them off.
Scare them? I'm scared.
Good job, Scooby. You've defeated the rats. Or rather, some sort of rat-like special effects creatures.
Oh, boy, Scooby Snacks.
This looks like a...
Any food? When you do, just look for me in my trusted Porta kitchen, and I'll cook us up one of my delicious meals. Smells like you found some food. Sweet, sweet chocolate. Like, hurry up and bring back more food. I'm famished.
Don't move.
Like, what mess did you get into, Scoob?
I call it mubber. A remarkable soy-based formula that can take any shape. And it only breaks down under UV light. Isn't that right, Marcy?
With Mubber, Mr. Stanton has perfected the most lifelike special effects monsters ever.
And would you believe it even tastes good?
Yummy!
Mr. Stanton, pleased to meet you. I'm Fred, this is Daphne, Velma, Shaggy, and Scooby-Doo. We're friends of Jed Jones.
Jed? That thief? Look around. He caused all this so he could steal my creations. He reprogrammed the animatronics monsters, and now they're attacking people.
How can you be sure it's Jed?
He's missing. And so's my mubber, UV lamps, some animatronics. That's all the proof I need.
Mr. Stanton, I don't believe Jed would ever do such a thing. We'll get to the bottom of this mystery.
Do you have any idea where Jed could have gone? He had a delivery to Chinatown for the New Year's parade.
Chinatown. Jed's first stop.
Seems kind of quiet for a parade.
You should not be here. The dragon is angry.
Dragon?
And you are?
My name is Maggie Z. I'm in charge of the New Year's celebration.
We're looking for my cousin Jed. He was delivering...
Jeez! Where's Maggie?
Well, dragon or not, we'll solve this mystery.
We need some clues if we...
Hello, sir. I'm Fred Jones, and this is Daphne Blake from Mystery, Inc.
Hello.
Pleased to meet you. My name is Ho Fang, and I own this antique shop. Of course, there aren't too many customers since the dragon showed up.
What happened here?
Some of the New Year parade sponsors wanted a more modern celebration this year. They commissioned, how do you say, special effects.
Great! You found interesting.
I'm sure Jed could explain all this. We could find them.
Scooby-Doo!
How dare you disturb the peace of the great Centaur! Leave while you still have the chance!
Sounds like that Zentuo is one tough cookie.
Hi, guys.
Yikes.
You are marked by the curse of the dragon. Leave now before it is too late. Zentuo has spoken.
Look, a manhole. It looks like Zentuo went into the sewer. Something about this mystery smells fishy. Keep a lookout, guys. I'm going to find Fred and Daphne.
I can't see anything down there.
Ruh-roh, Shaggy!
This could be a key to some... This piece of metal... Oh, hi, Scooby.
Shaggy fell in the sewers.
Shaggy fell in the sewers?
Then he is lost. The sewers are Zentuo's domain.
Oh, no.
What do you know about this Zentuo?
He is a very powerful ghost who controls the great dragon. He has cursed this city. You should leave.
Do you know where I can find him?
One does not find him. It is he who finds you, like he found your friend.
Thank you. Thank you.
count on my best pal rescuing me. Bye, Shaggy. Scooby-Doo, like, where were you? Sunday or something. Yeah. That's the smell of fear, Velma. Fear! As well as fish, rotten eggs, stale rice, and, I do believe tarragon.
Has anyone seen Daphne?
Help! Help!
It sounded like it was coming from the temple. This looks like a bell you'd find in a... This is a counterweight. This is a pakwa, an important... You should try to get inside the temple, Scooby.
Let's try to find a way inside the...
Okay. Like I've had enough of these monsters, Scoob. While you're saving the day, I think I'll stay here and cook.
Good idea.
Hey, Scooby, have you got any food? more recipes.
Scooby?
Thank you.
I could get a suit like that. This is a packing slip for UV. This is a menu for. This is 11. All right, let's try to solve this mystery. Help me identify. I wonder why the animatronics have gone haywire. This doesn't add up. I wonder why the animatronics. I don't know. I wonder why the animatronics have gone. Of course, the fortune inside the giant cookies. Where do you think that dragon came from? You're right, Scooby. The dragon scale is made out of rubber, which means it was made by monstrous fright and magic. Ho Fong said the dragon had strange eyes. I wonder what he meant. That's it. Ho Fong said the dragon had strange eyes. I wonder what he meant. Good answer! Zen Tuo must have put UV lamps inside the dragon's eyes to deal with any renegade animatronics. I got it, Scooby! I know who the real culprit is. Let's find the others.
Look, it's Zen Tuo.
So, you thought you could defeat Zen Tuo? You and your mutt are no match for me.
Mutt?
Scooby-Doo?
Did you find any secrets? Thanks for for rescuing me, Scooby. That was very brave of you.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
Zentuo is on top of that warehouse.
The power of Ps2! mean?
Now let's see who Zen 2-0 really is.
It's Maggie Z. It was her disappearing act that gave her away. Quite a trick, until I realized she was conveniently near a sewer entrance. Using the dragon as a distraction, she could drop down into the sewer and be gone.
Nice try, Mystery Ink.
Like she's not real, she's Mummer.
You can't catch what you can't hold.
That sounded like a man's voice.
I know what you're all thinking, that voice. I know Jed, and that wasn't him. Place?
I've pinpointed the source of Maggie Z's radio transmissions. This is it.
Like, are you sure they didn't come from that burger joint we passed earlier? I'm just asking.
Wait, I know this place. Rock and Roller Coaster Land. It's a theme park started by one of my favorite musicians, the Guitar Ghoul.
I don't like the sound of that.
Who is this Guitar Ghoul?
Nobody knows. He appears and disappears. Where and when he wants to.
And who are you?
Alvin Wiener, the Guitar Ghoul's biggest fan. Tonight, he's on a rampage. He's frightened everyone else away.
I'm a Guitar Ghoul fan too.
Really? Well, he is one of the greatest guitar players of all time.
Have you seen the Guitar Ghoul tonight?
Oh, yes. What a wonderful, terrible sight he was.
Smells like they found some food. Like bringing more ingredients, and I'll like make more recipes.
Hey, Scooby, any luck finding a clue yet?
Uh-oh.
What's this? A clue? Let's have a look at it. This is a ticket for the haunted house attraction. The Guitar Ghoul may be hiding there.
going.
Yikes!
How's this for a ride?
Oh no! Scooby-Dooby-Doo! Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
So, have you found any clues?
Yes, thanks to Scooby. According to this surveillance tape, the park has been plagued by a number of disturbing events.
Like, would you define disturbing, please?
First, rides started going crazy. Then animatronics began chasing people around. It was as if they had a life of their own.
This sounds like sabotage.
Here's the strange thing. The signal controlling the robots seemed to be coming from Ghoul Mountain in the water park.
Okay, gang, let's split up and look for clues. Scooby and Shaggy, you check out the water park. We'll try to find Alvin and learn more about this guitar ghoul.
I was afraid he'd say that.
This tape shows attractions going out of control and... These springs come from the hamburger-shaped trampolines. Maybe the guitar ghoul uses them to move around.
Thank you.
Like Scoob, wait for me! Hey! Isn't that this guitar ghoul guy? Let's have a look. One thing's for sure, this guy rocks. Get it? He rocks! Raggy!
Thank you.
you are, Waggy. Hey, Scoob, boy, am I glad to see you. Look what I found, a giant water slide. So what do we do now?
I know! Let's have a sing-along!
Zoinks! The guitar door!
That's what you get for going head-to-head against the guitar ghoul.
Hey, guys! Like we found someone! Nikki Starlight, right?
Please, call me Nikki.
Like she was the Guitar Ghoul's girlfriend.
So why are you here, Miss Starlight?
Like you, I'm trying to find out what's happening here. I can tell you this much. The Guitar Ghoul would never harm anyone. He couldn't possibly be behind this.
Even though the clues say otherwise?
Help!
That sounds like Daphne. Daphne?
It sounds like she's in the circus area.
This is a tour album for a band called Deaf Potatoes. Hey, doesn't the lead guitarist look like Alvin Wiener? Seems to be part of some food stand decoration. Maybe it's a clue to the Guitar Ghoul's hideout. This is a key to a souvenir stand. Maybe that's where the Guitar Ghoul is hidden.
You're a good dog.
Yes, you are.
Oh, where?
Zoinks! Look, Scooby! Daphne's in a cage!
Shaggy! Scooby! Over here!
You go on and try to find a way to reach that cage, Scoob.
Thank you.
snacks. Scooby-Dooby-Doo! Monster! Okay, now I'll activate this.
Music for an old Guitar Ghoul hit. Funny, it's attributed to NS. Tennis ball. Maybe this comes from a Midway attraction. Maybe it's a clue to the Guitar Ghoul's hideout. This is the hammer for the strongman's bell. Perhaps the Guitar Ghoul hid something important in there. Sure, for a circus sideshow. Perhaps we'll find clues to the Guitar Ghoul's identity there. Cool, we've got enough clues. Now we need to find which ones are real. I wonder how the Guitar Ghoul managed to sabotage all rides without anyone noticing. Interesting. The videotapes show an intricate network of tunnels connecting all rides. The Guitar Ghoul must have used them to move around unnoticed. There's something strange about that Alvin Wiener. I wonder how he's connected to this. No, I don't think that's it. There's something strange about that Alvin Wiener. I wonder how he's connected to this.
I don't think so, Scoot.
There's something strange about that Alvin Wiener. I don't know. There's something strange about that Alvin Wiener. I wonder. wonder how he's connected to this. Scooby, you won't believe this. Alvin Wiener was lead guitarist of Duff Potatoes, a one-hit wonder band who once opened for the Guitar Ghoul. I wonder what Nikki's real relationship to the Guitar Ghoul is.
I don't think so, Scooby.
I wonder what Nikki's real relationship to the Guitar Ghoul is. Guess what, Scooby? According to the name on this sheet music, Nikki wrote the Guitar Ghoul's biggest hit. Wait, I think I've got it. The Guitar Ghoul is about to be singing a new tune because this mystery is almost solved.
So, you kids think that you can catch me? Think again. The Guitar Ghoul is unstoppable. Be warned, my music is always loud and the hits never stop.
He's got to be broadcasting from the House of Mirrors. Let's go.
Oh boy, Scooby Snacks.
Something just for you. Let's see if you can survive it.
One, two, three, four!
Prove anything. Besides, I'm the victim here.
What do you mean? Daphne, what we have before us is a story of jealousy. Mr. Wiener's band, Deaf Potato, was never a real success. He blamed his failure on the guitar ghoul, whom he saw as a rival.
Wait, so like you blamed yourself?
Not quite. He was offered a way to destroy the guitar ghoul, literally from the inside. All he needed was this costume. Scooby?
Mummer!
Of course! Who gave you that costume, Mr. Wiener?
They didn't offer their name. Just a chance for revenge.
By sabotaging the Guitar Ghoul's popular theme park.
I would have gotten away with it, too, if it hadn't been for you meddling kids.
So, who's the real ghoul?
And why is he hiding?
Not he. She!
Yeah, Velma's right. I am the real guitar ghoul.
But why the secret identity?
I wanted to share my music, not my life. So I created the guitar ghoul disguise. Perhaps this could remain our little secret, huh?
Like our lips are sealed.
Thanks, I appreciate it. In exchange, I've got some information which you might find interesting.
They sure are doing a lot of renovations here.
Well, as long as the cafeteria is open.
From what Nikki heard, that place where Jed worked, Monstrous Fright and Magic, provided most of the new interactive exhibits here.
All right, gang, let's split up and look for clues. Hey, you can't be here. The museum's not open yet. And no dogs allowed.
Frogs? Where?
Hello, sir. I'm Daphne Blake from Mystery Inc. We're here to help you with your monster troubles.
Oh, sorry. I'm Joe Grimm, Chief of Security.
Mr. Grimm, when did these strange occurrences start to happen?
About 2 days ago, I'd say. It's those new exhibits, the dinosaurs and the suits of armors and the caveman.
Caveman?
A caveman, you say?
Look, I don't know nothing, all right? Just that strange things are going on here.
Oh, boy, Scooby Snacks! Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
Good evening. I'm Fred Jones from Mystery Inc.
I'm Professor Stoker. Mystery Inc. Aren't you the monster hunting kids? This is about the caveman, isn't it?
Can you tell me more about that caveman?
There is no such thing. It is a scientific impossibility. It is a hoax. That's what it is.
I see.
Are you the museum's curator?
De mere vivante, at your service.
I'm Velma Dinkley, and this is Scooby-Doo.
Charmed.
We hear you've been having troubles with some of your exhibits.
Interactive experiences, dear. Some of the robotic characters have gone out of control and scared away most of the workers.
Interesting.
Thank you.
here!
Scooby chips! Scooby snacks!
Some awesome barbecues.
Barbecue? I'm hungry.
Well, guess what I have?
All right, a drumstick.
Now, wait a minute. I was saving this for a special occasion.
Shaggy, your drumstick!
Thank you.
Scooby-Doo!
That's quite a prize you got there, Scooby. Can I see it?
Good work. Maybe you guys can check out the medieval room while I investigate the undersea exhibit with Daphne.
Hey, Scoob, I'll bet you they have some kind of barbecue in there.
Oh, boy, a barbecue!
There's some greasy black fluid on this dinosaur bone. This is a replica of the planet Saturn, named after the Roman god of time. Perhaps this has a hidden symbolic meaning. This metal chain may have been used by the caveman to scare away workers. This looks like a broom closet key. Maybe we'll find information about who the caveman is in there. Wow, Professor. This museum must have changed a lot.
Not for the better, I'm afraid. This isn't science, it's entertainment. I
I can't stand it.
Do you know what that Vivante woman wanted to call this venerable institution? An amuseum. A muse and museum. A museum. Can you imagine?
That's, catchy.
It's idiotic.
Do you think we could examine the undersea exhibit?
Well, it's kind of dangerous.
Don't worry. This is what we do for a living.
Like, maybe they'll have a delicious medieval sampler platter in there. Yeah!
Of that caveman story Mr. Grimm was talking about.
We'll check out the undersea exhibit as soon as the guard lets us in.
Hello, Scooby-Doo.
Fred always says, let's split up and look for food.
Okay. Raggy, what happened? Oh, no. Raggy. Walking armor.
Thank you.
Yes, walking armor.
Yeah. Oh, Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
Guys, any luck?
Well, Scooby found this.
It seems to be some sort of contract. Jinkies!
Zoinks!
That's the undersea exhibit. Quick, guys, we have to save them. This sword looks as if it was damaged through high voltage. Maybe the caveman used it to short out the lights. Was signed between Monstrous Fright and Magic and an anonymous company to share, quote, fringe benefits of museum operations, end quote. This looks as if it was part of a suit of armor. Maybe it was worn by the caveman.
Is that Scooby?
Thank you.
There's still the problem of us being trapped in a cage.
No problem, Fred.
Good job, Scooby. Let's go find the others.
A videotape of the caveman holding Fred and Daphne. Maybe that wasn't a live feed after all. This seems to be part of the scale model of the museum. Maybe that's a clue to the caveman's hideout. The caveman must have used this to film himself with Fred and Daphne, to make it look as if it was a live feed. Reading glasses. Could these belong to the person hiding under the caveman's mask? Cool. We've got enough clues. Now we need to find which ones are real. If the museum's not open yet, why are the dinosaurs outside operational? I'm pretty sure that's not the anthem. I don't think so. If the museum's not open yet, why are the dinosaurs outside operational? I'm pretty sure that fake dinosaur bone is covered in crude oil. Maybe the bobbing dinosaurs are really oil pumps. Do you think Monstrous Fred and Magic knew their dinosaurs were being used as oil pumps? The contract. It awards Monstrous Fred and Magic a share of secondary revenues from the museum. They must have known about the oil. One thing puzzles me. When you rescued Fred and Daphne, the video monitor still showed them being held by the caveman. I don't know. That doesn't make one thing puzzles me. When you rescued Fred and Daphne, the video monitor still showed them being held by the caveman. I don't think so. One thing I don't know. One thing puzzles me. When you rescued, I don't think so. One thing puzzles me. Wrong answer, Scooby. One thing puzzles me. No, I one thing puzzles me. I don't think one thing puzzles. No, one wrong answer. One thing puzzles me. Of course, the caveman filmed himself in front of Fred and Daphne, then fed a loop of the tape through the camera surveillance system to throw us off. It all adds up, Scooby. We may have just solved this mystery. I think I've got it figured out.
Zoinks!
There! It's the caveman!
Scooby-Doo! Like, where were you? Like, the sooner we find Jed, the sooner we can have lunch. So...
Hey, Scooby-Doo! Of course! It all makes sense! Let's go find the others, Scooby.
monster! Oh boy, Scooby Snack!
Hi, Scooby-Doo!
What's up, Scooby-Doo?
Thanks for rescuing me, Scooby.
I can't believe I fell for that trap.
Out front. It's a petroleum reserve. And those bobbing animatronic dinosaurs are covering pumping machines.
And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it hadn't been for you meddling kids.
It's got to be worth a fortune.
Oh, it is. We could make a deal.
We don't make deals with criminals, Mr. Grimm.
Besides, wouldn't you have to check with your partner first? The one supplying you with mubber?
Monstrous fright and magic.
Two for two, Fred. Scooby found a contract that points right back to Stanton. And if I'm correct, the answer to Jed's disappearance.
Stanton sent us on a wild goose chase.
All right, gang, let's fan out and find Winslow Stanton.
Oh boy, Scooby Snacks!
If Velma's right, then Stanton will have a lot of explaining to do.
I don't think we'll find any more.
Oh boy, Scooby Snacks! Scooby-Dooby-Doo! Next.
of them.
Look!
Cousin, do you mind blasting the rest of this, too?
Just as I suspected. Jed was trapped in that costume.
She's right. I was framed. I discovered that Stanton was up to no good, so he trapped me in that costume to prevent me from ratting him out. I was in there the first time you came by.
Jed, I'm so glad you're all right.
Thanks to you, cousin.
You won't get away with your lies, Jed. You won't get away, period.
It's Stanton. Sounds like he's in the miniature city set.
Well, well, well. Did you really think you'd get away with this?
Thank you.
dogs!
Somewhere. The jig is up, Mr. Stanton.
Is it?
Why, there are two of you!
Scooby?
Mubber!
It
That's Marcy.
Indeed, Fred. It seems Marcy was trying to frame Stanton, not Jed.
Marcy. But why?
Because I helped create Mubber, but you took all the credit for it. I thought that if I gave you a bad name, I could start up my own business.
Mr. Stanton, is this true?
Marcy, I didn't know you felt this way. You should have talked to me about it. Destroying the reputation of Monstrous Fright and Magic would destroy Mubber. I'm sorry if I hurt you, Marcy. I'd like you to become a partner in the company. If you can forgive me, that is.
Yeah, I think I can do that.
Another mystery solved.
Are you coming, Shaggy?
Just making myself something for the road. I call it a Mubber Witch. Huh? What gives?
Now that's what I call a light snack.
I'm a head.
The trees begin to moan, and the monsters grunt and groan, rotting faces full of slime. Don't you know it's terror time?